Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good day to all of us. I hope all of you to stay healthy in this pandemic situation. Go out if really necessary. Don't forget your mask and hand sanitizer. Wash your hand regularly and take a shower, obviously. I bet you guys heard that message countless of times, and I bet you guys get bored by it too. But today, I will introduce you to something unique, a theory called the butterfly effect. The butterfly effect is the idea that small thing can have a non-linear impact on a complex system. The idea is imagine a butterfly flipping its wings somewhere across Africa and causing a typhoon somewhere across Europe. And as John Gribbin writes in his cult classic work, Deep Simplicity, some systems are very sensitive to their starting condition, with a tiny difference you give them causing a big difference in where they end up. And there's a feedback, so that what the system does affect on its own behavior. Basically, small thing that we do will have a massive effect for someone else's life. For example, when you go to school using your motorcycle and then your motorcycle suddenly broke down when it's already green light, people behind you will honk at you and yell at you, right? And then your motorcycle comes back on and then you go about your day as if nothing really happened, just a broke down motorcycle. But did you know, people behind you lose their job because they left to the meeting? Or this is this guy's last day to seeing his dying mother at the hospital bed, just because your motorcycle couldn't move at the right time. We never knew. But even though it's something bad, it doesn't mean it always had a bad effect for everyone. For example, the bombing of Nagasaki. The US initially planned the attack to the city of Kuroko with the munition factory as its target. But the day US planned the attack, the city of Kuroko were nowhere to be found. The weather was very cloudy. The military personnel decided on the city of Nagasaki, and we know the rest. We cannot even begin to comprehend how different the history might be if that day wasn't cloudy at Kuroko. The World War II could still be very well going on, and our beloved country of Indonesia could still be at the hand of Japanese. Did you guys realize that these theories are deeply related to our current situation, the pandemic situation, the COVID-19 situation? One person transmitted the virus to another, then another, then another, then another. All of these things happened by a single tiny virus. We can see people smiling. We can touch freely. We can eat in our favorite restaurant, and we can watch movie in our favorite cinema. But even though it's something bad, it doesn't mean there's no good thing coming out of this, as I said earlier. We've seen people helping each other. We've seen people giving food, clothes, even shelter, money to help the economical crisis at this pandemic time. This is humanity at its best, not when we fight each other. COVID-19 has given us big effect in all aspects of our life. Economic, education, health, social life. People lose their loved one. People lose their job, and all of these things happen by a single tiny virus. An individual, a person, one entity, and this person and this virus could making the biggest butterfly effect in our decade. Big company were bankrupt, not just the big one, but the small one too. Entrepreneur at the university level, the high school level, all of them goes bankrupt. Just like this person that I knew very well. He's still in a high school bench. In fact, he doesn't even have a driving license or ID yet. He's not the smartest kid. He's not the best looking kid. He's not the most richest kid in the class. But he got a big dream, and he knew what he needed to do to make that dream a reality. He started going out with friends who had more experience than him, taking notes along the way, always asking for advice, always asking for opinion. And finally, he opened his clothing store. He is ecstatic. He's selling it to his family, to his friend, to his cousin, to the schoolmates, to the rest of the school, to the teacher. It gets better and better and better. He feels like he's at the top of the world. He had the car. He had the girls, he had the motorcycle, he had the designer clothes. But then, COVID-19 happened and his business hit an all-time low. He couldn't sell his product, he couldn't produce its product. He almost lost everything. He almost said, I'm give up. I can't do this anymore. But suddenly, out of nowhere, he rise up to the challenge and said, I'm gonna launch myself back up to the sky. And he did. He hired a promoter, he hired a marketing guy, he opened his store online at Tokopedia, at Shopee, other e-commerce as you know it, and his business got even better than his standard business when it's not COVID-19. COVID-19 almost beat him, but he rise up to the challenge. Do you guys know what I'm talking about? Do you guys know who almost went bankrupt? That person is me. The one who almost bankrupt is me. The one who almost said that I'm give up, that is me. If you keep using your negative lens, it's always gonna be negative. Unless you replace it with a positive one, it's gonna be positive. If I keep having negative thoughts, maybe I went bankrupt by now. I wouldn't be here right now. All you need to do, just keep, stay positive. And what I'm meaning to tell you is, never give up and believe in yourself just like I do. The point is, never give up, always find the best solution, the best at this pandemic situation. And finally, we can get through this together and humanity will prevail. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Dustin Muhammad Rizky from BPI1 High School.